it's often presumed by people who don't know you that the fact that you read engineering at Cambridge must in some ways have informed the work that you made later on that has a kind of constructed quasi-engineering quality to it. Do you still maintain it had absolutely no bearing on what you eventually did?
Well, I don't think it had much bearing on it, but I mean, that was the side that I would have gone, if I'd gone into engineering, I would have gone into making bridges. I would have gone into that sort of things. And in fact, when I look at Maillart's bridges, or some of the bridges, you know, that are made, they're marvellous. They're marvellous pieces of sculpture. And I suppose there is that slight connection of real and making things real things and making things that stand up and so on. But there's no immediate connection in the way that people are saying, you know, did you make things using beams and so on? I didn't.
Which was more formative for you? Your years at school at Charterhouse or your time at Cambridge?
I hated my years at Charterhouse. And I don't feel anything good about them at all. Cambridge was much better.
What was it you hated about Charterhouse?
Oh, let's talk about it. It was a horrible place. And I think actually, now when I see my grandson at 15, he's doing fine, actually, but I realise it's a dreadful time of a boy's life and probably a girl's life too, because you try to behave like a man, but you actually got the body and the metabolism of a child, and you know you're having a constant sort of tug of war between you. And Cambridge was. At last, one was a person. At last, one was a person, and able to make friends of other people who thought similarly. Or, you know, I had a lot of friends who were interested in religion in Cambridge, and I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the sort of conversations we had, the sort of times we spent together. It was wonderful. And funnily enough, last week we went to Eton, only because I was meeting my son Tim at Heathrow, and he had to catch another plane. So we had to go and have lunch somewhere fairly close, and it happened we chose a place in Windsor, and we went through Eton. And I saw Eton College, and I thought, these boys will never get over this. Eton will leave its sort of stamp and its mark on them. It's happened too early, because it's like Cambridge or Oxford, but it's 5 years too soon, and they'll never get over it. And I think it's borne out a lot in the old Etonian friends I have, you know? Whereas I think what hit me, that sort of atmosphere was what I got at Cambridge, and I didn't get it at Charterhouse at all.